मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम टू योर ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ बायोलॉजी स्टूडेंट्स दिस इज योर थर्ड क्लास इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द सेल स्ट्रक्चर दैट इज प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द सेल स्ट्रक्चर एंड स्टडी द सेकेंड पार्ट दैट इज न्यूक्लियस द मेन फंक्शन ऑफ द न्यूक्लियस इज टू कंट्रोल एंड रेगुलेट द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ द सेल एंड कैरीज द जीन So here we should first know that what actually gene is. Gene is a unit of heredity which is transferred from parent to offspring and is held to determine some characteristic of the offspring. So students, gene is actually the factor which is transferred from the parent to the offspring during the process of reproduction. That is when the cell divides, when the genetic material, when the genes are nucleus are divided, at that time the gene is transferred from the parents to the offspring. This is the reason that every offspring has a minimum amount of resemblance with their parents. They look like their parents, yet they have their own identity. They are not exact copies of their parents, but they still resemble their parents in some aspects. And that is because they have the genes of their parents. So this gene is that factor which is transferred from parents to the offspring, or you can say it is the heredity material which is transferred from one generation to another generation. So gene is present in the nucleus of the cell. That's why nucleus also have a quite importance because it contains the genetic material or the gene in it. Okay? Now next is, what is the location of the nucleus? Usually we have two kind of cells, that is animal cell and plant cells. So in case of animal cell, the nucleus is present in the center of the cell. It is present right in the center. But in case of plant cell, it is present in the periphery. Periphery means in the surroundings of the cell, or you can say in the corners of the cell. And the reason behind this is that the vacuole, you will study about vacuole later, that there is a very huge and big vacuole present in the plant cells which takes most of the space in the plant cell. That's why the nucleus is pushed in the periphery, and that's why it is present in one of the sides of the cell. But in case of animal cells, the nucleus is present right in the center, because vacuoles are either absent, or even if present, they are very smaller in size. All right. Now next is the structure of the nucleus. The structure of the nucleus mainly contains of four parts, that is the nuclear membrane, nucleoplasm, nucleolus and chromosomes. We will discuss about all these four parts one by one. So first is the nuclear membrane. The nuclear membrane is very much similar to the plasma membrane of the cell. As you have studied in the last class, that the cell contains of an external boundary which is known as plasma membrane or cell membrane. Similarly, the nucleus also is bounded by an external boundary or an external lining, the limiting lining, which is known as the nuclear membrane. Cell has cell membrane, nucleus has nuclear membrane. Similarly, like the plasma membrane or the cell membrane, this nuclear membrane is also a double layered membrane which separates the constituents of nucleus from the cytoplasm. The way by which the plasma membrane separates the constituents of cell from its environment, in the same way the nuclear membrane separates the constituents of nucleus from the cytoplasm of the cell. Okay? It provides a limited area to the nucleus to work. Again, similar to the plasma membrane, this nuclear membrane is formed of lipid bilayer. You have already studied in the last class when we were discussing about the fluid mosaic model. There you have already studied that the plasma membrane is made of lipid bilayer. Here also the nuclear membrane is also made of lipid bilayer. The plasma membrane provides shape to the cell. Similarly, the nuclear membrane provides shape to the nucleus. Okay? Next is, the outer layer of this membrane is combined with endoplasmic reticulum or ER. Students, you will study about endoplasmic reticulum in your upcoming classes, but for the time being you should know that out of these two layers, the double membrane of the nuclear membrane, the outer one, the external one, okay, which is towards the cytoplasm, there are many endoplasmic reticulums which are binded with it, or you can say combined with it. or in a simpler way you can say that endoplasmic reticulum is attached to the outer membrane of the nuclear membrane. Okay, now on the presence of this nuclear membrane, cells are usually of two type, that is, as you can see here I have written, eukaryotic cell and prokaryotic cell. Okay, so let me tell you here, eu means true, karya means nucleus. So eukaryotic cell means the cell which have true nucleus, pro means early, and karya means again nucleus. So prokaryotic cell means cell which have early nucleus. Now what is the difference between these two? The cell where the nuclear membrane is absent, that is the nucleus is somewhat exposed in the cytoplasm of the cell, they don't have a well-built nuclear membrane, those are known as the earlier nuclear cell, that is the nucleus in them is in their earlier stage, the nucleus is not completely formed. Okay, so those are known as cells with earlier nucleus, prokaryotic cell. Okay, similarly the nucleus where the nuclear membrane is completely formed, or the cell which have a nucleus with a well-built nuclear membrane, they are known to be eukaryotic cell, that is a cell with true nucleus. Eu means true and karya means nucleus. So the eukaryotic cell means a cell which have a true nucleus. You may say that the prokaryotic one were the earlier nucleuses, or you can say the earlier cells, while the eukaryotic one are the later complex or advanced cells. Only few bacteria are present which have prokaryotic cells, otherwise most of the organism, all the advanced and complex organisms have eukaryotic cell, because the nuclear membrane in them is completely well built. Okay, next is nucleoplasm. The cell has a homogeneous matrix fluid in it, which is known as the cytoplasm. Similarly, the nucleus also has a homogeneous transparent colloidal liquid with variable consistency, which is known as the nuclear sac or nucleoplasm. Okay, so you can say that this is the inner lamina of the cell. Okay, here the nucleoplasm is the inner lamina of the nucleus, and the cytoplasm is the inner lamina of the cell where different materials are present to function different things. So here in the nucleoplasm, in the nuclear sap, you will mainly find the nucleoproteins, ribose, sugar, enzymes. Though it is not required for you here, but still I would like to add one thing, that when you talk about the nucleoprotein, ribose sugar, enzymes, these are the main constituents to build the genetic material. Okay, just right now I told you that the nucleus contains the genes, the heredity factor which is transferred from one generation to another. So this heredity factor or the gene is basically made up of DNA, okay, deoxyribonucleic acid, and this DNA is made up of this ribose sugar, nucleoproteins and all. So all the materials which can build up the gene, or the materials to make the gene, is present in the nucleoplasm. Okay, the next is the nucleolus. Nucleolus is somewhat a solid spherical shape, darker structure which is found inside the nucleus. This contains ribosomes, and you will later study about the ribosomes. The main function of the ribosome is to produce protein. Let me tell you one thing here, students, that most of the things in our body is made up of protein. Even in cells, most of the things are made up of protein. DNA is also a protein in nature. So this nucleolus actually provides that protein. It does not directly forms the protein, but it forms the ribosomes, and ribosomes are known to be the protein factories in the cell. So nucleolus is actually the protein producing part of the nucleus. Last we have the chromosomes. Chromosomes are actually the part which constitutes the genetic material, or which contains the genes, or you can say the strings of DNA. So chromosomes usually are found in the form of very thin thread-like structures, which is known as the
chromatin matter. But later on, when the cell is about to divide or when the cell is undergoing reproduction process, at that time this chromatin material, they condense to form a thick structure which is known as chromosomes. So basically, if you want to know that what chromosomes are that part of nucleus which contains the genetic material or which contain the gene which is to be transferred to the next generation. Those genes are usually in the thread-like structure which is known as chromatin. But later, when they are to be passed on to the next generation, when the cell requires to divide, at that time those chromatin material condenses to form the chromosomes. Okay, to make my points more clear, here I have drawn a structure of the nucleus. You can see here, this is the nuclear membrane, this is the double layer nuclear membrane. In the next class, when we will be discussing about the cell organelles, you will see that the endoplasmic reticulum is somewhat found over here, attached to the external membrane of the nuclear membrane. This entire fluid matrix, which is the lamina, which forms the main lamina of the nucleus, is known as the nuclear sap or the nucleoplasm. This spherical portion here, which is the factory of ribosome or which is responsible for producing protein, is the nucleolus. And this thread-like structures, which you can see here, is the chromatin, which contains the gene in them, which contains the DNA in them, which later condenses and forms somewhat like this X-like structure. This is the chromosome, students. This is the structure which is formed. This is the structure which is formed after the condensation of this thread-like structure during the process of reproduction. So this was all about the nucleus. Again, I would like to discuss that nucleus controls the activities of the cell and contains the gene. In case of animal cell, it is present in the center. In case of plant cell, it is present in the periphery. If you see the structure, you will see that the nucleus contain mainly four parts: the nuclear membrane, which forms the boundary; the nucleoplasm, which forms the lamina; the nucleolus, which provides protein; and the genetic material, which is actually the main thing which is found in the nucleus. And because of this thing, the nucleus has the most importance in the cell. So I hope you have understood whatever I have taught today. That's all for today, students. Thank you. Have a good day.